Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. If you found this tutorial helpful, please thumb up and also click on the subscribe on the right side in the lower corner. I really appreciate it. In this lecture, we are going to learn how to use this vibration sensor with Arduino. This module sends signal when a vibration happens, not motion. For example, if you move it like this, you will not see anything. But if the vibration happens, it sends signal to Arduino. And using Arduino, we can control a buzzer to make a sound, or maybe control a relay to control alarm, light, fan, or trigger and do something else. This is the vibration sensor module. We have three pins here. The right pin is VCC. Then we have ground. And the last pin on this side is DO, digital out or data out. We have two LEDs. One is for power. The other is when it is detected. But the operation of this one is the opposite. When it does not detect, the light is on. When it detects, the light will be off. And this is a potentiometer that you can adjust the sensitivity of the module. This is an operational amplifier that amplifies the signal and sends high or low depending on the condition. This is the actual sensor. So this is the actual sensor. When the shake happens, it creates contact or communication between the pins. And here also we have on this side label VCC, ground, and DO. Here is the wiring diagram that I have drawn using first thing. This module was not available. I've inserted using Photoshop. From the right, VCC have been connected using the white wire to 5 volts. The middle pin, ground, using gray wire have been connected to the ground. And the data out have been connected using a purple wire to pin 2. I've connected my buzzer to pin 8. You can connect anything else you want, for example, a relay that can turn on or control something else for you. And here is a wiring on actual device. From the right, VCC have been connected using this white wire to pin 5 volts. The middle pin have been connected using gray wire to the ground. And the last pin, which is DO or data out or digital out, using a purple wire have been connected to pin 2. And for the buzzer that I've used here, pin 8 have been connected to one point, and from the ground of this Arduino, from this point, I've brought it to these two points. And the buzzer has two pins. The longer pin is positive. This will be connected to the pin that is connected to pin 8. Let me now explain the code. We are defining pin 2 as a vibration N pin. So this is a pin where the vibration pin will be connected as an input to Arduino. And we are defining a pin for relay. In this case, I'm going to test with buzzer to just make sound, but you can connect a relay as well. Pin 8 have been defined for that purpose. And on time is the amount of time that after detecting the vibration, it stays on. So you can play with this. And off time is the time that it waits until it goes for the next iteration on checking. Inside the setup, we defined the serial monitor as usual with 9600 watts, so you can read the data on the screen. And using pin mode, vibration in pin, we are defining as an input. That's pin 2. This is as if we type here 2 as an input and relay pin as an output. This is as if we type 8 here. And this is just a text for our own information. All this code inside the setup will run once. Inside the loop, which runs continuously, we read the vibration in pin using digital read. So this will read the result of the pin, either high or low. Compare it to see if it is high. These two equal sign means compare. And if that is true, if this statement is true, because we have F, three lines or action lines that is taken when the vibration is detected. So it's up to you to use it for your own application. And in my case, I am turning on a relay pin high. So this is as if I type 8 high, and then we wait for this on time that we define above. If this is not true, which means if the vibration has not happened, we use else, and we take these three line action. First we turn the relay low, in my case the buzzer will be turned off, or the relay will be turned off, and then also we print this text on the screen piece, and we wait for this off time, which is 200 milliseconds or less or more, whatever you like, you can change it, and we will wait, and the loop will continue taking this action again. And here is the demonstration. As you can see, here it shows peace, so it's quiet and the device is running. This light is the opposite. Unfortunately, they designed it such that when there is no vibration, it is on, and when vibration happens, it goes off. But other than that, everything works fine. As you can see, there is, it shows peace, and we don't hear any. As soon as it is shaken, it prints also shaken, and you can see that the device, the alarm goes on. But if, for example, you want to change this to something longer, for example, this on time, every time the shake happens, you want to stay on for a long time, change this, let's say, for 2 seconds and off for whatever short period. Let me update it. Now, if vibration happens, it stays on for 3 seconds. And you can control the time easily to whatever time you want. And the time off, it will be quickly ready back. But if you keep this off for a longer period, it also can stay off and ignore the upcoming next vibration. So play with this until it works for your specific application. The sensitivity of this device can be adjusted using this potentiometer, so it has not detected anything. And with this one, you can set the sensitivity. Even now it's shaken. I can go to the right, or maybe go to the left. So I just go at the edge where it goes off and it goes on. So this is now the most sensitive. And if you want it less sensitive, when the light goes on, go a little more further to the right. This way the sensitivity will be decreased. This was how to use the vibration sensor with Arduino. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.